Welcome, everybody. It is 2:17 here in New York, and as we noted, a very busy day all up and down the I-95 corridor from D.C. all the way to the corner of Wall and Broad. Now, this new Congress has much to do, but job one is still jobs. As John Boehner said, nearly 1 in 10 Americans is still out of work. Housing, too, remains weak. But despite this, there seems to have been a rather seismic shift in sentiment. We've gone from doom and gloom to a stock boom, and now fears of inflation, all in a matter of weeks. David Castillo is not convinced that all is well, but he does remain calm. David is managing director at Further Lane Securities and joins us now. Thanks for your patience, David. It's great to see you again. Is all well? The stock market says everything's better.
You know, I think that's the story that they're going to go with. But I think you and I, who have stayed pretty close and watching the housing market, which is what we really focus on at Further Lane, insofar as residential mortgage-backed securities, is that the consumer is still in terrible shape. You know, I think the, you know, John Boehner said in his announcement, you know, 1 in 10 Americans are still out of work, and it doesn't look like they're going to find anything big going forward. People's homes are still underwater. I mean, if you think about it, you know, 10% of Americans are still are delinquent on their mortgages right now. You know, consumers aren't confident. We've got a confidence level from the University of Michigan, puts it in the mid-70s, which is nowhere close to being very positive.
David, let's highlight a couple things. I mean, listen, retail sales, the MasterCard spending pulse numbers up 5.5%, and people say, look, retail's back. But if you dig into those numbers, you find that it's really the top 10-20% of the population that is spending all the money, while many Americans remain mired in debt and, like you said, a house. I'm bringing up a chart right now that Bob Shiller turned us on to. He was on last week. He remains negative on homes. Basically, he's saying that looking at 100 years of housing data, if we just reverted back to the historical mean on home prices versus income in the economy, we've got another 20% down in home prices nationwide. Do you agree?
Yeah, I mean, I would concur with that. I don't know if I think 20% may be the, you know, the outlying figure. He does a great job with his numbers. However, you know, I also have a lot of confidence in, let's just say, value opportunity out there in the market. But I do think home prices, especially in certain areas, have an opportunity to decline further.
Where is the value opportunity, as you put it?
You know, I think what has to happen right now, and I've been approached by, you know, different people in the mortgage origination process as well as in the lending process on where value is. I think specialization is beginning to occur in detailing and dealing with troubled mortgage situations, homes that are in foreclosure, homes that are in short sale situations, homes where the borrower is attempting to renegotiate or modify loan terms. And that process is still really difficult. I think opportunities come along as we find increased specialization in trying to accelerate that process. Expertise insofar as you know, going through the, I guess, the new origination process in homes. Banks are starting to open up a little bit on the lending. You're seeing it both in residential and commercial. And you're also beginning to see, although new home although home sales are pretty darn low, you know, in and around 290,000, it has peaked up a little bit from the bottom. Yeah. So I'm seeing people out there bottom fishing and looking around. And I think if you check in any of the larger metropolitan markets, you're beginning to see a pretty active business in people hanging around the courthouse waiting for that foreclosure process. People with checks ready to buy and taking advantage of the opportunities.
In other words, the free market is starting to do its job. David, we've got to leave it there, unfortunately, because the open ran a little bit long, but we'll get you back on very soon. I know you got a lot of original ideas. We'd love to hear them. We'll get you back on very soon. Thanks for your patience, David.
All right. Okay, Brian. See you later.
All right. David Castillo, Further Lane Securities. All right. On deck, the Dow already up about 1% this year following last year's big gains. Professor Jeremy Siegel says, get ready. This could be the beginning of a big bull run. He's here to detail why. Stick around.
FoxBusiness.com. For all the business information you need right now, giving you the power to prosper.
For years now, Monex, America's trusted name in precious metals, has been telling you about the many advantages of owning gold. But did you know there's another precious metal that many feel offers even more potential than gold? That's right, it's silver. And over the last few years, silver has more than doubled in price. Might that suggest a significant opportunity for you? This special report will show you why some